Today we're going to take this woman and give her clothing a brand new style. Hello and welcome to an Affinity Revolution tutorial. My name is Ezra Anderson, and today we're going to learn how to add new designs to clothing. If you'd like to follow along with the same images that I'll be using, I've included a download link down in the video description. After opening up today's images inside Affinity, the first thing we're going to do is come to the picture of the jellyfish and copy it by pressing Command or Control C, and then coming back to the picture of the woman and pasting it by pressing Command or Control V. Next, we're going to lower the opacity of this layer by clicking and dragging on the word opacity. Then I'll come grab the Move tool and reposition the jellyfish so it's on top of the woman's clothing. Now that we have the new texture properly positioned, we're going to enter the Liquify persona. So you can come up to the top and press on the Liquify persona icon. Inside the Liquify persona, we want to warp the picture of the jellyfish so it looks like it's wrapping around the woman. To do this, we're going to click and drag on the edges of the jellyfish picture to push them in towards the woman. So I'll come over to this corner and click and drag to push this picture in. I'll continue coming around the rest of the woman and pushing in the jellyfish picture so it looks like it's wrapping around her. After you're done warping the picture of the jellyfish, you can come up to the top and press Apply. The next thing we need to do is make a selection of the woman's jacket. To do this, I'm going to uncheck the layer of the jellyfish, and then select the layer with the woman on it. Now I'll grab the quick selection brush, and paint a selection across her jacket. We now have all of her jacket selected, but we also have the zipper selected, which we don't want the jellyfish texture to be applied to. To remove this from our selection, we're going to use the Refine Selection dialog box. So I'm going to come up to the top and press Refine. Now I'm going to switch to the background mode and use my paintbrush to paint on top of the zipper to remove it from my selection. I'll zoom in a little bit by pressing Command or Control Plus. And then I'll use the left bracket key to make my brush smaller. Now I'll paint on the zipper to remove it from my selection. After you've removed the zipper from your selection, you can press Apply. Now I'm going to press Command or Control 0 to see my entire picture again. And then I'll click on the layer of the jellyfish and check it back on. And with my selection still active, I'll press on the mask icon to apply a mask to this layer. Now our picture of the jellyfish is only being applied to the area that we selected. We no longer need our selection, so you can press Command or Control D to deselect. Our jellyfish layer still has a low opacity though, so I'm going to click on this layer and click and drag on the word opacity to return it to 100%. As a finishing touch, I'm going to change the blend mode of this jellyfish layer from normal to hard light. To see our before and after, I'll uncheck this jellyfish layer so we can see the original jacket. And here it is with the jellyfish texture applied. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you want to learn even more about Affinity Photo, you can check out our complete beginner's guide to Affinity Photo by clicking on the link down in the video description. We cover all the tools and techniques that you need to master this program. So check out the course, and I'll see you in the next Affinity Revolution tutorial.